Hi guys, welcome everyone. In this video, we are going to talk about the basic features of the Active Inspire. First of all, I go to click the file and then I will go to settings. We have to learn something here. First of all, we will talk about the layout. What is the layout? Here there is an icon size. With this icon size, as you see at the right side, you can change the size of the icons. If you want to make it large, you can make it, and you can make it smaller. And main toolbox, there is a colors options. You can put the 8 colors or 16 or 24 colors, but my advice for you, use 16 colors, but it's totally up to you. And then I will go to commands. I will not talk about all properties of the Active Inspire today. I will talk about the some basic features. Let's make it smaller. Yes. Commands. Here, commands. Whatever you want to add here while using Active Port, whatever you want to add there, you can put it from here. Some of them I added before. I can remove them first of all. Or what I want to add to here, I have to choose it. First of all, for example, what can I choose? Let's see. For example, spotlight. I edit. And ruler, I can edit. Dice roller, I can edit. Calculator, I can edit. There are many things. Whatever you want to add, you can add. But everything are not necessary for the lesson. And then when you add them to here, as you see, it's appear here. And when you click on the done, that means you edit. If you don't click on the done, that means you didn't edit. Now I am going to talk about the sidebar properties. And here we have some icons, and that means we have some tools. What can we do with this? And firstly, I can remove the welcome text to trash box, and then we can discuss about all of this. First, we have here compass. With this compass, we can adjust its angle, and wherever we want to put it, we can put, and then we can draw a circle with it, as you see. Or we can draw a smaller circuit, smaller circle, and we can change also its color. And when you click here, you can close it. When you select them all, also you can send them to trash box. I will go to next page and I will look at the another properties. This is the calculator. If you are in the math or physics or chemistry lesson, you might need this. And for fun, you can use the dices. You can roll the dice. You can change the number of the dice. And you can roll it, and you can adjust its speed. And here there is nice properties. This is the ruler, and you can draw some straight lines, and you can adjust its an angle. As you see, when I bring the mouse here, I can change its angle, and now it is 0 degree, and I can easily draw a straight line with it. For example, if you are in a physics lesson and if you are talking about the optics subject, you can use these options. And I will go another page, and as you see, the ruler is still here. How can you remove it? When you click on here options, you can close it. What else? Here As you see, handwriting recognition. When you click on this, if you write something, it will turn it into normal text. And side of it, there is another one, shape recognizer. And when you draw a shape, for example, let's say this square, it will convert it almost straight line. But I am drawing it with mouse. As you see, it doesn't appear clearly. But if I draw a line, it make it directly straight. But if you use it on board, it will more useful. And I will select the mouse again. And here there is a circular spotlight. If you are in the lesson, if you want to show only one part of the board, you can select this. What did I write here? As you see, all. And on the board, only they can see all. And you can expand the size of the circle. And wherever you want to move it, you can move it. And here there is an options, you can close it. And what else? Here, there is another desktop tools. With desktop tools, you can go to desktop. And here there are some options. Some of them are useful for your lesson while preparing any document with your Active Inspire program. Here you can take snap picture, snapshot. For example, with this one, if you click on it, you can take the picture of this part to your page. And how can you go back? You can go back when you click on this Active Inspire, it appears directly return the flip chart. As you see, it's a picture and it appears on your chart, on your page. And you can maximize or minimize it. But here the point at the right down point, if you minimize it or enlarge it, as you see, it is minimizing and enlarging properly. But if you use this side, that means you compress it or you stretch it. But from here, it's gonna get smaller or larger properly. I will go to another page. Here with this option, you can text on, you can write on the directly where you can write on the desktop. When you click on it, you go back. And what else? Here, there is a pen tool. You can change the color of the pen marker, we can say, from here. You can pick the orange or another color. And with this one, you can make it thinner or thicker, like this. And here there is an eraser. With the eraser, also you can adjust the size of the eraser from here. You can erase what did you write. And I will write something with the black color. With the black color, I picked the black color, let's say. And here there is a highlighter. You can use the highlighter. If you are using some text on your page, you can highlight it, important point, like this. And you can change the highlighter colors from here. If you want to make it pink, you can. What else? You can. And this one, you can fill the colors to page. If you want to use the black color, now everything is black. If you click on something, it will make that black. Let's go to the next page. Now I will talk about the shapes. When you click on shapes, here there is a line, rectangle, rounded rectangle, and square, circle, triangle, ellipse, and there are many other shapes. Whatever you want to use in your lesson, you can use them. Here there is a color options. You can change the color. For example, if you pick a black, it's filled with the black color. Here there is another option of the colors. As you see, these colors decide the outline and this color decide the solid color. And here if we shape the if we choose this, that means it is colorless. We can say like this, you can draw a rectangle, or you can draw, if you want to draw a perfect square, as you see, you can draw a square. And after drawing, if you want to adjust it, you can pick the mouse, and when you click on it, as you see, there is some points around it. You can minimize it or you can make it larger than. And here there is another option. I will go to the next page. There is another option. You can draw the lines, and you can change the color of the lines by choosing from the color box. You can draw it like this, and you can draw an arrow. What else? You can draw this shape, as you see. Text. When it appears, when you click on the T here, it means you can text whatever you want to text. Now I can text. I will use screen keyboard from here. Make it more understandable. I will text all. So as you see, I text it here, and I can change the, when you select all, I can change the font, or I can change the size of the text from here. And you can make it, when you select it, you can make it bold, or you can change its color, so, or you can put it center like this. And here there is another properties. It says clear. When you click on it, clear annotations, clear object, clear get it, clear the page. When you click on the clear annotations, there is no any annotation because we didn't write anything. If we write something here, if we click on it, if we say click annotations, it's only erase what you write with the pen. And when you click on it, if you say clear objects, it's clear only objects. And what else about the pen tool? For example, you write something on board, and half of the board, all is, half of the board is full. So what can you do? My advice for you, you can select the mouse option, and you can select them all. You can minimize what you text on the board, and you can shift it wherever you want. And how can you fix this sidebar to here? Here there is an option. When you come on it, when you click on it, as you see, it's hidden. When you put your marker or your mouse on it, it's appear. But if you click on the pin toolbox, it never disappear. Or there is another option, you can send it to top, or you can take it back. And also there is another option here, toolbox option. You can duck it left, right. I prefer to right. You can put it top, bottom, floating. You can make it whatever you want, you can make it. And let's talk about the page browser. Here there is a page browser. You can go to any page in a fast way directly. Just we put here 6 page, but if it is about 70 or 80 page, it's hard to go from page 70 to 10. But with the page browser, it becomes very easy. And here you can adjust the page. So on here, it appears more number of pages. You can switch from one page to another page easily. And here there is a properties of it, also page browser. You can take it right, you can make it floating, and you can make it close. And when you click on it, you can pin it here. As you see, the main screen shift a bit right. But when you click on this, when you need it, come on it and it's appear. Otherwise, it disappears. I prefer this way. And there is also another option here. You can make the all this one full page. You can use the F5, or you can use the, when you click on this, the screen, as you see, the main screen, it seems a bit larger than when you are writing. It might give you more space to write. When you click on it again, it turns back to original one. Now I will go to next page, and our main page is white now. How can I put there a background, and what kind of background I can put there? When you click right, the options appear here. As you see, set background. You can fill picture here. You can fill the colors here. You can choose the color, for example, this color, and you can choose the options here. The center is shiny here. Solid color, for example, when you say the apply, it turn on the this color. And you can take the snapshot from the desktop, or you can fill it with the image. You can find the, any image you want. You can put the background, and when you say apply, it's appear there. But here, as you see, this part doesn't seem fit. So here there is an options, best fit, stretch fit, center. You can put it center, or you can, I'm using generally best fit. When you say best fit, it put it the, on the best. When you say okay, as you see, you cannot change the position of the background. I will go next page. You can set another background. You will go to image, you will browse, and you will choose any picture you want. And when you say apply, it's applied. But as you see, if you choose best fit, apply, it's perfect. Or you can stretch fit. As you see, it's appear like this, stretch it a bit, but I like the best fit. When you say apply, you can change it, but when you say okay, it stay there. And after, whatever you want to do it, you want to text on it, you want to draw on it, whatever you want, you can do on it. Another, let's go to another page. I will choose the mouse tools, and I will talk about the grid design. When you click right, here there is a grid designer. This is useful for the math lesson, physics and chemistry lesson, especially if you are working on the vectors in physics. It is very useful for drawing. What does it mean? Here there is an option visible. When you make it visible, as you see, there is a grid on the page, and you can change its color of the grid. You can change it, you can make it blue, whatever you want, and you can make it, you can change the line style. You can make it dot, can make it cross, solid lines, dotted lines, and dashed lines, whatever you want. You can roll down and you can change the design. I prefer this one. Whatever you prefer, you can use it. And when you click on the close, it's appear there. If you want to draw on it, or if you want to text on it, it is in your hand. It's totally up to you. And now it's the kind of background we can see. And I will go another page. How can you insert the text to the page? And there is one option, you can copy it from any document. For example, when you copy it, you can paste it here directly. And then if you double click on it, you can change its color, size, or you can change the font. Another option, here there is a T. When you click on it, as you see, the text option appear, and when you click on the any free place on the page, it's written type here. You can type whatever you want, and when you go to mouse option, you can shift it anywhere you want. When you double click on it, you can change any of its properties. So in this way, you can type on the page. Let's go another page and talk about the different properties. And how can you insert picture to the page? The one option, you can take the screenshot. For example, you wanna take the picture of this. Picture of this to the page. What can you do? You can click on this desktop tool, and you can here there is a snapshot camera. You can choose the area snapshot, and as you see here, you can adjust. You can shift this. You can adjust what part of the picture you want to use. And if you want to put it current page, you can put current page or new page. It's up to you. I will put it the current page. There is a sound, and when I go back, as you see, the picture appear there. And from this part, this point, if you enlarge it or minimize it, as you see, you can do. But here, you can stretch it or compress it. This is the one way to add picture. The another way to add picture, I will go to another page. Another way to add picture, you can copy this, you can copy it, you can paste it. As you see, but it appear with its original size. In this case, here there is an option, you can minimize it. Or from here, you can minimize it, as you see, but in this way, not the part of the picture, you add here full of the picture. And I will teach you two more options. I think they are important and necessary for us. I will go to previous page. Here there is a option. I will copy it first of all to the another page. I will pass it here, and you can add, I will change it, picture. You can add picture on this word. How? When you click on it, as you see, there is an options appear here. When you click on this, here, insert link to file. When you click on insert link to file, when you go to desktop, Active Inspire, any picture you want to put on it, you can. And when you click on the picture, here there is an option store externally, store in the flip chart. I prefer this one. You can store it in the flip chart. And you, when you click the OK, now when you bring the mouse on the word of picture, as you see, there is a button of to play. When you click on it, your picture appear here. And what can you do? The another picture also, you can put it here in the same method. You can insert another picture, for example this one, store in the flip chart. Okay, when you come on it and when you click on it, it appears here, as you see. And you can take the picture of it to the page. How? I click on the camera. As you see, it appears here. There is another method which you can add the picture to the page. I will go to the next page and I will take one icon and I will pass it here. For example, this is your icon and you can insert this icon to picture. Did you see what did I do? I choose the insert link to file and I will choose any picture what I want. I will choose this one, let's say. I will store it in flip chart and okay. As you see, when I come on it, there is a play button on it. When I press on it, the picture appear here and I can open it. And I can take this picture to do my page like this. Or if you are talking about any animal or any flower or any herbal, you can text or you can put icon and you can insert picture in it. And then when you click on it, it appear there and it will make your lesson easier, what I can say. And this is the all about inserting picture. And how can we insert the video on the Active Inspire? The one method, which is similar as the picture, copy the video. This is the video you have to download it and paste it. It will appear like this, any part of your page, wherever you want to put it, you can put it and you can make it larger or you can make it smaller. And here there is a button of the control. You can play it, you can pause it. And also you can insert the video on a word. For example, text something here. For example, you are talking about the momentum and this video might be about the momentum. And when you right click on the text, insert the link to file. When you insert this video, you might say store in flip chart. When you press OK, as you see, when you come on it, it's appear there, a play button. When you press this play button, the video appear. If you double click on the video, it will be full screen. If you double click again, it will be not a full screen. And there is a play button and you can send the video forward like this, and or you can make it larger and you can adjust its sound or you can decrease the sound and you can take any snap from the video like this. I will close it. It will be like this. So it can be useful in the lesson. And also if I put here icon, I will put the same icon. It doesn't matter for me. When you click on icon, there is options. From the options, insert the link file. And when you put the video, don't forget to say store in the flip chart. When you say OK, as you see, the video appear again with the same system. And this makes your lesson plan more visual and better than another lesson, we can say. So in this method, you can insert the video. And now I will talk about how can you insert the simulation to the system. The one method, first you have to learn what's the simulation. You can shift it directly to here. As you see, the icon appear here. Wherever you want to shift it, you can. And when you click on this icon, the simulation start opening. So in this way you can use your simulation in your lesson like this. And I will close it. Also in the another method, you can add the simulation to the icon. For example, I will use same icon again. We will use same method, insert link to file. You have to download that simulation before, double click on it, store in the flip chart. Okay, and when you press on it, it will start during your lesson For example, this one, I like this one. You can use in your lessons. For example, you can choose any constant fixed icon for your simulation. You can add your simulation into it. Now I will discuss about how can we insert the link to the page. Firstly, you have to open the link. You have to copy it. Then you have to go to insert from the here. And you have to choose website. And when you pass it here, you can insert your link to here and wherever you want. When you click on it, it will open directly that link. You can set like this. And another option, you can insert that link to the sentence. Any sentence, insert link to file. You can insert that link to sentence. You can put it from your insert link website, and you can put it on image, icon, or action object, existing object. You have to check the existing object. The one is this, the other one is this, the other one is this, and you have to choose this text. When you click on the OK, and when you paste here your link, that means you add it here. When you click on it, it will go directly to your link.
Hi, I'm Brad Callen, and in this video, I'm going to show you how anyone can quickly and easily create doodle videos.
This is just the hat from this video. As you see, it comes to there. And I will put it with the same method to the website, to the existing object. I will choose this one, icon. And I say OK, OK again. As you see, the play button appear on it. When I click on it, it will go that link directly. You can see, as you see. And I will talk about the design mode. Here there is a button. When you click on it, as you see, all around the sentence and the icon, the red box appeared. Why? It means they have some extra properties. They have some actions on them. And when you close the design mode, they will disappear. So if you forget what did you put on any object, you can click on the design mode. They will appear. Or for example, when you right click on this, if you say this is the hidden, you can hide it. As you see, it is not there anymore. You cannot see it. In the design mode, you can see it there. And I will talk about another properties. Export file to PDF. The one export, you can export all page to JPEG picture, I mean, or PDF, or you can do same thing from here. You can say print, and when you say print, you have to choose color, and you have to choose orientation of the page from the page setting orientation. You can choose landscape. Okay, and then here there is a button export to PDF, and you want, if you want to convert to PDF all, you have to choose all, export to PDF. And let's go to desktop, Active Inspire, untitled, let's say. I'm exporting it to here. It will take some time. And as you see, when you open the PDF file, whatever I have done before, they all appear here. But to videos and all other actions not available. You can convert only picture and the text. And let's return back to here. I will talk about some other properties of the picture. I think they are important. When I copy this picture to here, let's say, I will minimize it a bit. If I wanna write something down here, science display, if I write something, yeah. When you click on the picture, as you see, there are some tools here. This is to maximize, and this is to minimize it. And this one to double it. You can make it double, as you see. I will put it, drop it to rubbish bin. You can make it translucent or transparent directly, or you can make it fully opaque. And here you can go to options, copy, paste, delete, transform, locked. If you make it locked, you have to lock it with the other one, and you can make it hidden like this. As you see, it doesn't appear there. You cannot see it, but it doesn't appear there. If you open the this mode, what mode? Design mode. As you see, you can make it unhidden, and in any mode it will appear there. And another options, with this one you can shift it anywhere. With this one you can rotate it however you want. And the other important options for you, it can be useful. For example, as you see, when you put the, there is a sentence here, this sentence, when you put the picture, it's behind it, and you can send this picture behind. How? If there is a two button, this one send it back, as you see, this one take it front. You can do it like that, or you can do same thing with the text, send it backward or send it forward like this. This is important. I think it can be useful for your lesson. Thanks for listening.